Jumper Cat, at your service. Bad guys bagged, catastrophes stopped. And this is my buddy, Superdog. He helps me out sometimes. You know, on the small stuff.
I see. With almost everyone gone, it's kind of lonely for me here. Would you boys care to join me for a lunch of fish eggs?
I'll have mine scrambled.
Thank you, Princess, but we have to patrol the city.
Hey, why not come with us? We could show you all the sights.
Squidward's last name is Tentacles?
Poor guy.
Fancy. So that's what came in the mail. Looks like Gary has a new little playmate.
Dream on, SpongeBob. I wouldn't let Snelly here play with that mongrel mutt. She's a purebred.
Wow, a snail made out of bread.
No, purebred means she's of the highest pedigree. See, she even has her own papers. So if you'll excuse us, Snelly has to start her training.
Training?
For the Bikini Bottom snail race. Snelly will be winning this Sunday.
Sunday?
Well, I guess I can't enter Gary in that. Sunday's laundry day.
No, SpongeBob. You can't enter Gary because Gary's a mutt.
Boy, you got that right. Gary's no... Hey, what makes you so sure Gary couldn't win that race?
Papers.
Property of Squidward Tentpoles.
That's tennis ball! Tentacles! Come on, Snelly.
You know what? I'm starting to get the idea that Squidward thinks his snail is better than mine.
No.
Patrick, are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Yeah, I should get a snail and enter it in that race and beat Squidward.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking? No, no, no. I'm thinking about entering you in that race and beating Squidward's snail. Looks like we're going to start our training now, ladies. I call you a lady to humiliate and demean you. It's a motivational tool we coaches use.
I don't know why, but I think I'll kick SpongeBob's butt tomorrow.
Why should I worry? Tell me, why should I care? Say I may not have a dime. Oh, but I got three sound bites, man. Why should I worry? Why should I care? Yes, just do what the nation. They love me at the Chelsea, they adore me at the Ritz. Why should I worry? Why should I care?
It's okay, Rocky. You go when you feel like it.
Gary, are you listening to me? Get the anchors out of your pants right now! Don't give me that look! I said now, mister! Get going, Gary! Go, 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 go!
And there goes number 7 out of the starting gate. Oh, hang on, folks. He doesn't look so good.
Not good enough, Gary! Not good enough! Faster!
I do not like the look of this.
Come on, Gary, it's a race! A race! Have you heard of them?
That coach is pushing that snail too hard.
Faster, Gary! Faster, 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 faster!
Huh? Oh, looks like number seven has a blowout. Oh, make that two, folks.
Gary?
Plus a blown head gasket. Oh, and the poor creature's still going for it.
Gary, you can stop now.
And he's losing control.
You can take a break now if you want to, Gary.
He's spinning out of control. He's heading straight for the wall. Coaches seems to have raced onto the track. That is an automatic disqualification. Looks like number six has this race all wrapped up, ladies and gentlemen.
Come on, Snelly. It's all you, Billy.
Oh, Gary, I'm sorry. What did you just say? I was pushing it too hard.
Meow.
You did? Oh, Gary, why didn't you tell me I wasn't listening?
Meow.
You did? Oh, Gary. Oh, Gary.
What?
Gary? Oh.
My, oh my. Folks, I have never seen anything quite like this. It seems Snelly, the leader, just went back to comfort Gary.
Looks like you and I are in-laws, eh, Squidward?
That's impossible. If Snelly didn't win, then...
And the winner is Rocky!
I can't believe it. My purebred, which cost me $1,700, lost to a rock.
Don't worry, Squidward. I know how much you wanted to win, so I had the trophy engraved to you.
Gosh, Patrick, thanks. The first place snail racing cup presented to Squidward Tortellini. Will I ever win?